misrepresentation with the Pol body, qualified human trafficking with the Justice Department, and graft charges with the DILG and the Tarlac and Valenzuela courts, among others. Now, ex-Mayor Alice Guo is being looked at and probed for an equally grave offense that borders on high crimes and treason. As our Patrick De Jesus reports on the angle of espionage the DND and NSC are putting out in the open.
Authorities are now investigating the resurfacing possibility that former Bamban Tarlac Mayor Alice Guo is a spy. The information came from an interview with self-proclaimed Chinese spy Xie Xidiang in an Al Jazeera documentary where he claimed he was recruited as a spy in the Philippines in 2016. Xie is currently detained in Thailand and has been linked to forced labor and human trafficking through scamming activities. He also urged Alice Guo, whom he called Guo Waping, to tell the truth. According to the National Security Council, Xie's statements are being thoroughly examined, especially since he is facing an extradition case to be sent back to China.
This can also be part of a disinformation campaign on the part of Xie Xinjiang himself, no? Kasi nga, he is fighting extradition charges. So, since he is fighting extradition charges, importante rin sa kanyang ma-internationalize yung isyong ito to draw attention to himself, no? By saying, I'm an MSS spy at may mga kilala akong MSS spy para magkaroon ng simpatya sa kanya yung mundo para hindi na siya ma-extradite. Kasi sinasabi niya, pag tumuntong na daw siya sa kalupaan ng PRC, mamamatay daw siya.
In connection with this development, Defense Secretary Gibo Teodoro urged lawmakers to amend the espionage law, stating it is high time to strengthen its provisions against potential spies in the Philippines.
Ang mahalaga ngayon, parusahan natin ang espionage sa panahon ng peace. Kasi ang espionage law sa Pilipinas ay epektibo lamang during times of war.
For the secretary, whether Alice Guo is a spy or not, the illegal activities she is allegedly involved in are serious.
What is clear is that she is not a Filipino. Secondly, she falsified documents to pretend that she's a Filipino. And thirdly, she was an active co-conspirator to a massive illegal criminal enterprise kung saan nagmula ang lahat ng illegal na activities. But then again, it is curious that a 32-building complex was operating within 2 minutes flying time away from the Trade Dock and the Light Armor Division. And, you know, all the authorities should have been aware of this at that time, particularly the local authorities.
Teodoro also appealed to local officials not to be swayed by questionable donations or money that may come from international syndicates, which pose a serious threat to national security.
Because it is the easiest way to destroy the moral fabric, economic fabric, and social fabric of this country.
Maraming mga offers na magtatayo ng negosyo, magtatayo ng ganito. Dapat siya sa atin nilang mabuti kung sino ang nag-o-offer at kung ano ang tunay na pakay. Alam mo, walang negosyo na quick cash.
Patrick De Jesus from the National TV for a new and better Philippines.